Ghoulies 3 is a cheap and harmless B-movie that Puppet or Ghoulies fans would enjoy, but I still feel that Part 2 is the best of the bunch. And I'm pretty sure one of the Ghoulies has a serious drinking problem. Here comes the regular. Call out your name. Here at 80s Horror Central, I tend to review and discuss the forgotten B-movies of yesteryear. But this October, I was thinking about breaking down the hidden themes of Kubrick's The Shining, or diving deep into what makes Carpenter's original Halloween iconic, or perhaps a video essay on how the horror films of the 1980s reflected the economical, political, and social commentaries of the decade. Eh, but fuck it, let's just review Ghoulies 2. Ghoulies 2 is a 1988 supernatural horror comedy from Charles Band's Empire Pictures. It's an unrelated sequel to the surprisingly successful Gremlins knockoff, Ghoulies, from 1985. Despite being the most entertaining and well-made entry in the series, Ghoulies 2 was released straight to video, where it earned a cult following. And since it's been a while since I visited Satan's Den, let's head on down to the carnival and see if Ghoulies 2 is worth revisiting, and find out if they'll really get us in the end.
Carnival runs on magic.
A company runs on profit, and a company owns this carnival. Satan's Den's been losing money for 16 months. Our money. Your dead space on the Midway, and that costs us. You have until the end of the weekend to turn it around.
Satan's Den been part of this outfit for over 20 years.
Look, I'm concerned with the future. Pull your weight, or you get out of the way.
The Ghoulies are back and more devilish than ever, as they turn an unsuspecting carnival into a house of pandemonium. Satan's Den has received its final warning. Either the not-so-scary House of Horror spooks up its act and scares up some customers fast, or its gateway to hell will be closed for eternity. Just when Larry Prentice believes there's not a ghost of a chance to save his show, he gets some uninvited visitors to spice things up. The Ghoulies make Satan's Den their home, and profits soar as the demonic little creatures wreak havoc on the helpless fairgrounds. So take a ride on the Ghoulie go-round and play some bumper Ghoulies. Enjoy yourself, because the Ghoulies will get you in the end.
Puppy!
Oh, goddammit!
No!
What's going on?
It broke my tombs!
What?
Some bat around. I don't know what the fuck it was.
Puppy, let's go, please.
Okay, babe, we're going. Hey, man, bring my tunes.
Ghoulies 2 is an entertaining and silly little monsters on the loose movie that manages to take a fun idea and a nostalgic setting and use them both to good effect. This is not a horror flick for hardcore horror gore fans. I mean, the poster features a monster coming out of the toilet, so that should give you an idea what kind of movie you're dealing with. This is a B-movie aimed to entertain and elicit a chuckle or two out of silliness. But it's a sequel that is well-made, features competent acting, some decent special effects, and an endearing if not cheesy premise. The Ghoulie movies were cable and video store classics, along with another Gremlins cash grab franchise, Critters. The VHS cover alone got your attention, and as a kid, this was the first Ghoulies movie I rented and saw. Imagine my eventual disappointment when finally renting the boring and uninteresting original. The gore in the film is pretty minimal and the death scenes are pedestrian, but the movie makes great use of its haunted house setting and offers up a lot of fun. I also have to admit that I'm a sucker for movies that feature carnivals as its main setting. The film's setting of a traveling carnival helps lend the film an identity and also provides a refreshing and fun atmosphere. The Ghoulies all look great in this outing, as effects legend John Carl Beekler and his team return to do the effects. The characters in this movie are quite likable in this sequel, the supporting characters are all memorable, and the film features intentional humor that does elicit a smile the majority of the time.
Muffy?
Damn cat, where are you?
Hi, Betty. Where are you going?
I'm leaving this dump. You seen my little Muffy?
Who isn't?
I mean my kitten, Musclehead.
I think I saw him bite a Satan's Den.
The idea of the Ghoulies wreaking havoc at a carnival is ingenious, and the film's final act is a wild and amusing time. And I gotta say, the giant Ghoulie monster that the good guys summoned to eat and destroy the Ghoulies in the film's climax was the stuff of nightmare fuel as a kid. This movie also delivers what the original poster promised, a dude getting attacked while taking a shit. And I would be a chota boy if I didn't mention that classic Wasp song that accompanies the end credits of the film. Scream Until You Like It. It's one of my favorite 80s metal songs and arguably one of the best 80s horror songs of all time. How this movie didn't get a theatrical release is quite baffling, but I assume it had something to do with Empire's financial struggles at the time. This was the last entry to have any involvement from Charles Band, as he sold the rights to Vestron Pictures shortly after.
Dude! Your tunes!
Come on, guys. Stop fooling around.
Ghoulies 2 may not be a scary or suspenseful horror flick, but it's a fun and amusing one that would be a good watch on a crisp fall day this October, or if you're in the mood for some lighter fare. This would also be a good movie to show the kiddos if you're looking for something to watch with your kids this fall or trying to get them into horror, as it's quite tame and lighthearted. Thanks for watching Whorehounds and Fright Freaks, but remember, they'll get you in the end. Also, as an aside, I found it pretty humorous how all the characters keep reiterating how realistic, quote-unquote, the ghoulies look in the movie. So I always find that to be pretty funny.
Is that really scary, mister? I bet it's not. I bet it's stupid.
Oh, demons don't get you. You'll be all right.
My ass. We better get out of here. Dead rat meat. Holy shit.
Kill him.
Larry! Kill me!